Hi, I'm Jeff Bartikovics, the co-founder of TastingTable.com, here with our editor-in-chief, Scott Hawker, to talk about an ingredient that's the foundation of delicious summer cocktails and delicious summer cooking.
Absolutely. So everyone knows limes. You need one of these for both of those things. Let's talk about cocktails first, shall we? So this is a citrus squeezer. At Tasting Table, we use a lot of these. We make a lot of cocktails. We give them to a lot of guests. So what you start off with is take half a lime. The one trick about these is you would think you put the lime in this way in the same fashion as the squeezer is shaped. Wrong. Turn it upside down.
I did it the wrong way for years.
I did too. We won't talk about that. So what you do is squeeze, then you remove the half, repeat, cocktails, guests.
Awesome. As long as we're talking about limes, can you give us some tips on garnishing?
Absolutely. A good cocktail needs a good garnish. So this is a two-part zester. You have one side for the longer, fatter zests, and the other side has a bunch of holes where you get skinnier zests, more appropriate for summer cooking.
And I imagine that we can buy this at any cook shop.
Absolutely. So when you're trying to get a twist off of a lime for cocktails, you simply pull off a long strip, and then you typically start by wrapping around your finger just to kind of get your bearings for the spiral. And then if you pull, it gets even tighter, then you put it on the top of the cocktail.
Beautiful. Now, you made that look so easy, I can't imagine why you'd want to use any other technique for cooking.
Well, because for cocktails, it's all about getting as much juice as you can as quickly as possible.
Right.
In cooking, you have a little bit more time usually, so you can get at the maximum amount of juice from the lime, from each and every lime, in fact.
Can you show me how?
Absolutely. Go along the edge of it like this. You pull off long, thin strips of zest, which are perfect for summer cooking and ceviches. A little bit of bright pop. You can chop those into pieces. You can just use them in vinaigrettes. Lots of options.
Beautiful. It's much more delicate looking, and you don't get any of that bitter pith that you get with the garnish.
Exactly. You see the white parts there, not on the zest.
Got it.
Now let's talk about the way to get the most juice out of the lime for cooking. Cut off the edge, stand it on its end. You don't want to cut off your fingers.
Safety first.
Exactly. Then you cut three sides off of it, kind of like little half moons, and you end up with a triangle core.
Kind of feel like we're doing a garnishing class here.
Oh, we kind of are. And then what you do is you squeeze each part like this. Get lots and lots of juice.
You have one of those.
Absolutely.
Give it a whirl. Tell that. There's more juice getting out of here this time.
And then this time you have the core, you can also get some juice out of it. Squeeze.
Beautiful.
There you go.
Scott, a little messy, but thanks for the tip.
That's okay, the best kind of cooking is.
Got it.